Hiya folks, a couple of people asked me to do a video about Kinhin, and Kinhin is a kind of slow walking meditation that you do between two periods of Zazen. So first off, I'd like to show you how we do Kinhin at the Angel City Zen Center. The bell rings twice to signal the beginning of Kinhin. You get up off your cushion, fluff the cushion up, make a bow toward the cushion, and a bow away from the cushion. Then you turn to your left and start the slow walking Kinhin. The pace is supposed to be one step per breath, but as you'll see, I do it a little faster than that. When you reach a corner, you just stop and kind of turn like this. You don't have to make kind of a strange Tai Chi sort of move. I see a lot of people doing that. A smaller bell called an Inkin will be rung to tell you Kinhin is over. Then you walk at a normal pace back to your cushion, make the bows again. Sit on your cushion and start doing some more Zazen. The word Kinhin consists of two Chinese characters, and the first means to bind or to sew, but also can mean sutra, and I believe that this was because the sutras were originally bound together with thread, but don't quote me on that, because I'm not really sure, and I tried looking it up and I couldn't find the answer. The second Chinese character in Kinhin is just the generic verb to go. The word has been around for a long time. It appears in Chinese translations of the Vinaya rules, but there weren't really any instructions on how to do Kinhin. It was just one of the four postures of the Buddha, which are sitting, standing, walking, and lying down. Most of the information I'm going to give you about the history of Kinhin comes from this book called Zen Ritual. A lot of flash on that. I don't know, the light's weird in here today. But it's written by Stephen Hine and Dale S. Wright, fairly easy to find, came out in 2008. And here is a quote that they have from a Chinese source about Kinhin as it was done in India. In the five parts of India, both monks and laymen are in the habit of taking a walk, going straight forward and coming back along the same route at proper times when they feel like it. But they do not take walks in noisy places. First, it cures diseases, and second, it helps digestion. When noontime is approaching, or when the sun is to the west, it is time to take a walk. They may either go out of the monastery for a long walk, or just stroll slowly in the corridor. If one does not do so, one is liable to suffer from illness, being often troubled by swelling of the legs and of the stomach, or pain in the elbows or in the shoulders, or with phlegmatic symptoms which do not dissolve. Later on, in Dogen's writings, which come from a few hundred years after that, we get some mentions of Kinhin. Here he's talking about his teacher, Ju Qing, aka Tendo Nyojo, talking about Kinhin. Ju Qing was extremely pleased and had them do the practice of Kinhin along with the assembly. He had them line up separately after the nuns. He's talking about some Taoists who came to the temple to visit. In Dogen's references to Kinhin, he's usually talking about something kind of vague. He doesn't give you detailed instructions on how to do Kinhin the way he gives very, very detailed instructions on how to do Zazen. And Kinhin, in his usage, seems to mean either a kind of ceremonial walking or just a way to get in and out of the Zendo, where you're doing Zazen. Here's an example from Dogen's writings about getting in and out of the Zendo doing Kinhin. Do not let the feet get ahead and the body behind. Move body and feet together. Look directly ahead at the ground, one fathom ahead. The measure of the pace is equal to the instep of the foot. Be as though standing in one place, as though not moving forward. It is splendid to move slowly, walking in magnificent ease and quiet. Do not make noise with your slippers and rudely distract the assembly. When you are walking, clasp both hands together, putting them inside the sleeves. Do not let the sleeves dangle down to the right and left near your feet. And the position of the hands he's talking about, or at least as it's developed these days, is you take your left hand and make a fist with the thumb in the middle, and you put your right hand on top of that and clasp these at your chest. I've also seen it done this way. I believe Kodo Sawaki was famous for doing it this way. It's more standard to do it this way. That quotation from Dogen is from an essay of his called Bendoho. Here's another quote about Kinhin that comes from a piece called Hokyoki, which is the records of his travels in China, and there is some dispute about whether this is authentic or not, so we'll just leave that aside for the moment, but it certainly seems Dogenish. The slow walk consists of one step per breath. Take a step without looking at your feet, without bending over or looking up. Viewed from the side, it would seem like you are standing in one spot, for you must not move nor shake your shoulders or chest. Zhu Qing, that's his teacher, often walked back and forth between the east and the west in the Ta Kung Ma Ming Tsang Hall to demonstrate this to Dogen. He then remarked, "Nowadays, I am the only one who knows the importance of this slow walk meditation. If you should ask the abbots of all the corners of the world, you will surely discover that others do not yet know it." And there are some other quotations of his about Qinhin, but they neither describe the practice in any great detail, nor do they describe the practice as something that's done between two periods of Zazen as a way to kind of give your legs a break from the constant sitting. That didn't come along until the 1700s. In 1739, a monk named Menzan Zuiho published a piece called Qinhin Ki, and the Ki is just like instructions for, and it is a very detailed explanation of how to do Qinhin. And he pulls different quotes from Dogen and different quotes from older Chinese sources to try to give the thing a feel of authenticity or ancientness. But the scholars who've looked at it, including the people who wrote that book I've just mentioned, seem to think that it's mostly Menzan's invention, or at least it was something that had developed around the time that Menzan was alive, that he was trying to give it a kind of a veneer of ancientness. So there are various ways of doing Qinhin. As I mentioned in the video where I showed you of myself doing Qinhin, we do it a little faster. Some places, like at the San Francisco Zen Center, they really do it very, very slowly, to the point where it is kind of like what Dogen is describing, where you would think people are just standing still. We do it a little faster. I think our pace of doing Qinhin is about the standard one, as far as I've seen in other places, which is not that super, super slow walking. In the Rinzai sect of Zen, they do Qinhin really fast, and this surprised me the first time I sat with a Rinzai group, that they're practically running around as they do the Qinhin, and they don't kind of go around the Zendo. They sometimes go outside, or even if they're in the Zendo, they walk in zigzag fashions, and one person kind of leads the Qinhin, and they go fast, and it's different from the way that we do it in the Soto school. This word Qinhin is being used a lot to mean a whole lot of different things. You'll see it everywhere, and people often love to talk about walking meditation and meditation in motion. In fact, the chapter that talks about Qinhin in that book I referenced earlier is called Meditation in Motion. And a lot of people are really into this idea of meditating while walking, and you'll often hear people say different things about what is their meditation, like tennis is my meditation, or, you know, kayaking is my Zazen, whatever. I knew a monk who said that Zazen is my Zazen, you know, and what she meant by that is that Zazen is something very significant and important, and just calling everything that you do your Zazen and your meditation is a bit of a cop-out. And I agree with her on that one. Not everything is meditation. But a lot of people want to know how to do meditation while walking, and, you know, I don't know, honestly. I try to kind of keep the same mindset that I have in Zazen throughout the day whenever possible, no matter what I'm doing. But I'm not doing any sort of special technique to make that happen. I'm not, you know, concentrating on the feeling of my feet or something like that. I just kind of try to maintain that sort of focus that Zazen brings in my daily activities. So I don't really have any instructions for how to make your own, you know, walking to school or walking to the bus stop into a meditation. Just kind of stay with it and stay in the moment, as the kids all say. But I wouldn't really worry too much about that. Just do things naturally is, I think, the best policy. And if you remember that attention that you got from your Zazen in the morning while you're doing whatever it is, you're washing your dishes or drying your laundry or whatever it happens to be, then great, that's good. But making it a big deal out of trying to maintain strict focus, I think is just going to drive you a little bonkers. So I don't really recommend that. The other thing is that Kinhin for me is strictly something that I do when I'm in a group meditation and we're doing one period of zazen followed by another period of zazen. Because you can't really sit zazen for the longest I've ever seen a group do zazen is about an hour, and normally it's between 25 and 40 minutes. And at that point, your legs are starting to really get starting to have some difficulty there, and you need to get up and move around. And that's what Kinhin is for. Kinhin is for continuing the zazen while actually moving around. So it's another form of zazen. I don't do Kinhin at home. It's one of the reasons I shot that video at the Angel City Zen Center is there isn't really room in my apartment to do Kinhin very easily. And I don't think it's something that you need to do at home. It's a practice for when you're sitting with a group and, as I say, taking a break from one zazen period to the next. But doing it at home, I don't know. I don't know why you would do that. So there you go. That's my Kinhin video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to try to do one on Dharma Talks next. We'll see how that goes. And maybe I won't do that. I don't know. We'll see what happens. As you all know by now, I am supported by your donations. You can donate via PayPal and Patreon. The links are below. That's how I make my living. I really appreciate your donations. See you around later. Thanks and bye.